Director Renato Solidum of the Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology joins us on the line. Good afternoon and welcome to ANC again, Mr. Solidum.
Yes, good afternoon.
Yes, aftershocks as strong as magnitude 5 remain possible. In fact, we listened to a report from the NDRRMC a while ago. It has recorded over 109 aftershocks. How long is this supposed to last and how should residents prepare?
Well, the aftershocks can still continue for several days. As of 12 noon, we have recorded 194 aftershocks already. But the number of aftershocks have been decreasing significantly. So we will continue monitoring and see what happens. But definitely we need to make sure that residents are safe and for the local officials and engineers in the area to make sure that they inspect houses and buildings and certify if they can still be used.
Right. Since we've spoken yesterday, I'm pretty sure you've gotten more information about what happened in Batanes. Why was this quake seemingly more devastating even at magnitude 5.4? Was it because it was shallow or was it about the position, the geography?
Well, it was shallow. It was shallow and near the Ipayat Island. So essentially, this would render several houses and buildings damaged at intensity 6. Now, the magnitude 5.9 earthquake, which is stronger than the first one, caused further damages in many areas.
Right. Yesterday, you brought up an interesting point about houses in Batanes, a lot of them made from limestone. They do not have steel reinforcements, possible violations to the building code. How do we move forward from
this? These are traditional houses, but my suggestion is for the new houses to be rebuilt following the building code.
All right. Are you now with President Duterte? I understand he's supposed to arrive in Batanes.
Yes, we're here in a cabinet meeting, and I'm sending in a little while.
All right. We'll not hold you any further. Thanks a lot, Director Renato Solidum of FIVOX.
Yes, you're welcome.
Good afternoon.
Yes, thank you.